Welcome to a second lesson on subtracting integers with two-color counters. In this lesson, we look at subtraction problems where we have to add zeros in order to perform the subtraction using two-color counters. For review, we'll define a yellow counter as positive 1 and a red counter as negative 1. So two yellow counters is a way to represent positive 2, three red counters is a way to represent negative 3, and if we combine a yellow counter with a red counter, this would be equal to 0. And we can represent integers in more than one way using two-color counters. Looking at the counters here, notice because we have three red counters and three yellow counters, this would simplify to 0, leaving us with two yellow counters, which is equal to positive 2. So we could use all of these counters as another way to represent positive 2. Looking at these counters, notice how we have five red counters and five yellow counters, which would simplify to 0, leaving us with three red counters, which is equal to negative 3. So we could use all these counters to represent negative 3. Let's look at our first example. Here we have 5 minus 8, or if we want, positive 5 minus positive 8. Let's begin by representing positive 5, and let's use 5 yellow counters. Now because we have minus 8, we want to take away or remove 8 yellow counters. But notice how we only have 5, so we'll have to add zeros so that we have 8 yellow counters. If we want to have exactly 8 yellow counters, we'd have to add 3 more, which means we'd have to add exactly 3 zeros as we see here. Again, together, this would simplify to 0, so we still have positive 5 with the 5 yellow counters, but now it's in a form where we can remove 8 yellow counters. So if we remove 8 yellow counters, or these 8 counters here, notice how that would leave us with a total of 3 red counters, which is equal to negative 3, which means 5 minus 8 equals negative 3. Let's look at this problem again. Notice how last time we added just enough yellow counters so that we had 8 yellow counters to remove or take away. But we could add a whole bunch of zeros, or what we could call a sea of zeros, and still perform the subtraction. Notice how here we have 5 yellow counters and 5 red counters, which is still simplified to 0, so we still have positive 5 here. And now in this form, to subtract 8, again we want to remove or take away 8 yellow counters, which if we do, let's say we take away these 8 yellow counters, we'd be left with 2 yellow counters and 5 red counters, so we'd have to simplify again to find our difference. Again, 2 yellow counters and 2 red counters would simplify to 0, still leaving us with 3 red counters, or negative 3. 5 minus 8 equals negative 3. So there is more than one way to approach these types of subtraction problems. Let's look at a second example. Here we have negative 7 minus 5, or if we want, negative 7 minus positive 5. We'll begin by representing negative 7. Let's go ahead and use 7 red counters. So here's negative 7. Because we have minus 5 or minus positive 5, we now want to remove or take away 5 yellow counters. Notice how we don't have 5 yellow counters. So what we could do is add 5 zeros by adding 5 red counters and 5 yellow counters. Again, this is still 0, so we still have negative 7. But now in this form, we can remove or take away the 5 yellow counters. Notice if we do this, we take away these 5 yellow counters because we're subtracting positive 5. That would leave us with a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 red counters, which is equal to negative 12. So negative 7 minus 5 equals negative 12. Again, this is not the only approach to finding this difference, so let's take a look at this again. Again, starting with negative 7, we could add a whole bunch of zeros or a sea of zeros so that we can remove or take away 5 yellow counters. So if we added a whole bunch of zeros as we see here, because we're subtracting positive 5, it's now in a form where we can remove 5 yellow counters. So if we do that, let's say we remove these 5 yellow counters for minus positive 5, we'd be left with this, which would simplify again. Notice how here we have 5 red counters paired with 5 yellow counters, which would simplify to 0, again leaving us with 12 red counters, which is negative 12. So with their approach, negative 7 minus 5 is negative 12. I hope you found these two examples helpful.